Hello, and welcome to Friday's class. Tonight we're going to continue on the next prophet in the scriptures, Moses, which comes from the books Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy in the Bible.
Hello, 欢迎来到星期五的课程。今晚我们将继续下一位禁节里的先知摩西，他是来自圣经里的出埃及记、利未记及民数记。
2 weeks ago, we discussed Jacob's son Joseph, who was sold into slavery, thrown into prison, and became the second in charge of all of Egypt. Joseph saved Israel and Egypt during the famine, and now Israel has become slaves to Egypt. Let's begin.
两星期以前，我们讨论过雅各的儿子约瑟被卖为奴仆，被推进关进监狱里，后来成为埃及第二位大，且管理所有的埃及。在旱灾时期，约瑟拯救了以色列及埃及，后来以色列却变成了埃及人的奴仆。让我们开始吧。
The Pharaoh of Egypt saw that the people of Israel started to grow and grow. They had many children, and soon they would outnumber the people of Egypt. The Pharaoh started to worry that the people of Israel would fight back against the Egyptians and take over Egypt. Something had to be done to stop this from happening.
埃及法老王看到以色列人们开始增加繁殖，他们有许多的孩子们。很快的，他们的人数会胜过埃及人的。法老王开始担心以色列的人们会攻击反抗埃及人，还有攻取埃及。以防未来必须做些什么来阻止这事情的发生。
The Pharaoh sent out a command. All Hebrew baby boys would be thrown into the river, but the daughters could live and grow to marry Egyptian men.
法老王发布了一命令，所有希伯来人的男婴诞生后即必须丢进河里，但女婴可以得以生存，甚至长大以后嫁给埃及的男人。
One Hebrew woman gave birth to a son, and she did not want to throw him into the river to die. Therefore, she hid the child for 3 months. Then she made a basket out of bulrushes.She placed the child in it and gently placed it in the river. She had an older daughter follow it to see what would happen to it.
有一个希伯来妇女生下了一个儿子，她并不要她的儿子被丢入河里死亡，因此所以她将这孩子藏了3个月，然后她用香蒲草编织了一个篮子，他将这小孩放进篮子里，然后小心地将他放进河里。他让他的大女儿随后跟随着他流到哪里，去看发生了什么事情。
The Pharaoh's daughter was at the side of the river washing herself when she saw the basket. She asked one of her maids to go and fetch it for her.When she opened it, she knew that it was a Hebrew child. She had compassion upon the child and decided to raise him as her own son. She called him Moses because she drew him out of the water.
法老王的女儿正在河边清洗自己。当她看到篮子，她使唤她的一个女仆去打捞起来给她。当她打开篮子，你看，她知道那是希伯来人的小孩。他对这小孩起了怜悯之心，却决定像是自己的小孩子来抚养他。他叫他摩西，因为他是他从水里把他捞起来的。
When Moses was older, he watched as the people of Israel struggled to build the Egyptian cities. They worked very hard. They had been in bondage to Egypt for 400 years. One day,Moses saw an Egyptian beating a Hebrew man. Moses stopped him and ended up killing the Egyptian. He buried him in the sand.
摩西长大了，他看到了以色列人们挣扎着在为着埃及人建造城市，他们非常的辛苦的工作着，他们被奴役在埃及里有400年了。一天，摩西看到一个埃及人正在苦打一位以色列人，摩西阻挡了他，结果却演变成杀死了埃及人，他将他埋在沙里。
The next day, someone asked him about it, and soon the Pharaoh heard about what Moses did and wanted to have him killed. Moses fled to the wilderness to survive.
隔天有人问他有关这件事，且很快的法老王听说了有关摩西所做的事，也希望置他于死地。摩西必须逃亡到荒野地去藏起来生存。
In the desert near Midian, Moses rested next to a well of water. He saw 7 young ladies come with their sheep. Some bad men came and drove the sheep away. Moses fought them off and helped the ladies get water for their sheep.
在荒漠里靠近米甸的地方，摩西紧靠在一口水井旁休息，他看到了7位年轻的淑女赶着羊群来到，有一些坏人出现将羊群赶走，摩西起来保护他们，且帮助淑女们打水给他们的羊群喝。
The girls told their father what had happened, and Moses was invited to stay. Soon Moses married one of this man's 7 daughters, the eldest named Zipporah. Moses helped watch over the sheep for his father-in-law, Jethro.
女孩们告诉她爸爸，他们的爸爸所发生的事，所以摩西被邀请留下来。不久，摩西娶了这位男士的7位女儿之中的一位，就是最大的女儿，名叫西波拉。摩西帮助他的岳父叶特罗看顾羊群。
One day, as he watched over the sheep, God appeared to Moses up in the mountains in the form of a burning bush. But the bush wasn't burning or being consumed. God told Moses to take off his shoes because he was standing on holy ground.
一天，当他在看顾羊群们的时候，上帝用火焰似般的在荆棘里，向摩西显现。但是荆棘并没有着火或是被烧毁，上帝告诉摩西要脱掉他的鞋子，因为他站在圣地里。
Moses asked God who he was, and God said, I am that I am, and that he was the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He said that he was I am because God is everything. He said He is the Savior, He is the Creator, He is the Father, He is everything. He also told Moses that he heard the cries of his people and wanted Moses to go deliver them out of Egypt.
摩西问上帝他是谁，而上帝说，我是创始神中的主宰，我是，且是亚伯拉罕、以撤和雅各的上帝。他说他是我是，因为上帝即是万物，他是救世主，他是创造者，他是父亲，他是万物。他还告诉摩西，他听到他的百姓的呼求，且邀摩西去埃及，领他们出埃及。
Moses said that he could not talk very well, so maybe God could choose someone else. God sent Moses' brother Aaron to help him talk. And God told Moses what to do when the Pharaoh said no to the children of Israel leaving Egypt. Moses, his wife, and his son set off for Egypt.
摩西说他不能说话能力不够好，所以上帝差派摩西的哥哥亚伦去帮助他说话。且上帝告诉摩西要怎么做。当法老王说不准以色列 法老王说不准以色列的子民离开埃及，摩西他的妻子以及他的孩子们离开往埃及去。
Moses and Aaron went in to talk with the Pharaoh. They told him that the God of Israel would like him to let his people go. The Pharaoh said, No, I don't know this God, and I will not listen to him. Instead, I will make the Hebrews work harder, and I will not give them straw to make their bricks.
摩西和亚伦进去找法老王谈论，他们告诉他，那以色列的上帝喜欢他让他们的子民离开。法老王说，不，我不认识这位上帝，且我不会听他的，反之，我将会使希伯来人工作得更辛苦，且我将不会给他们草料去做他们的砖块。
Moses prayed to God for the people, and again God sent Moses to the Pharaoh, asking him to let the children of Israel go. The Pharaoh wanted a sign, so Moses had Aaron throw down his staff that he carried, and it became a snake. The Pharaoh asked his wise men and sorcerers to do the same thing, and their staffs became snakes as well. However, Moses' snake ate all the other snakes. The Pharaoh said, No.
摩西为了人们向上帝祈求祷告，上帝再度差派摩西去找法老王，请求他让以色列的子民离开。法老王要求信号信息，所以摩西使亚伦将他带来的手杖扔在地上，那根手杖变成了一条蛇，而法老王请他的占星家巫师们行使法术，也做了同样的事，而他们的手杖也同样的都变成了蛇。但不管怎么样，摩西的蛇吞吃了所有其他的蛇。法老王说，不。
The next morning, Moses went to the river to find the Pharaoh. He asked him to let the people go, but the Pharaoh said no. Moses did as God commanded. He put his staff into the water, and all the water of the river turned to blood, along with all the other water the Egyptians had in pitchers and other containers. They had no water to drink for 7 days.
隔天早晨，摩西去尼罗河找法老王，他请求他让这些子民离开，但法老王说不行。摩西做了上帝所命令的，他将他的手杖放进尼罗河里，而河里所有的水都变成了血水，沿途包括了所有其他的埃及的水源，像是罐子里的水以及其他容器里的水都变成了血水，他们没有水喝有7天之久。
Moses asked the Pharaoh again to let the people go, and when he refused, frogs were sent into the bedrooms and houses of all the Egyptians. They stayed until Moses asked God to remove them, but even seeing this, the Pharaoh still refused.
摩西又再度请求法老王让子民离开，当他拒绝时，上帝差使青蛙们跳进所有埃及人的房间及房子里，他们一直待着，直到上帝使他们离开。纵使法老王看到这样的事，法老王还是拒绝。
Moses kept asking the Pharaoh, and 8 more plagues came upon the Egyptians. The people of Israel were not affected by all of this, because God protected them. God sent lice to come, and the Pharaoh asked the sorcerers to do the same. They said they could not. They said it was only possible by the finger of God. The Pharaoh didn't listen.
摩西继续请求法老王，那有八种更多的灾难发生在埃及人上，而以色列人们并没有被这些灾难影响到，那是因为上帝保护着他们。 上帝降下施灾，而法老王请巫师们也做同样的事。巫师们他们说他们无法做，他们说那只有借着上帝的手才有可能，而法老王并不聆听。
Next came swarms of flies, and they went all over Egypt, and God caused that all the cattle of the Egyptians should die. All the cattle that belonged to the people of Israel were fine.
下一个蝇灾临至所有埃及人的各处，且上帝使那所有埃及人的牛群死亡，但是那些所有属于以色列人民的牛群是不受到这个影响的。
After that, the Pharaoh kept saying no to Moses. So God caused all the people of Egypt to be covered in boils. It was disgusting and painful, but the Pharaoh still refused.
那蝇灾之后，法老王还是继续与摩西说不，所以上帝就让埃及人们得疮灾，那是很恶心难闻的，以及疼痛的。但是法老王还是继续拒绝。
Next came large hail and thunder. The hail was like fire sent from the sky. It destroyed many buildings and crops growing, and it killed many people. Yet the Pharaoh refused.
下一个降临巨大的冰炮和闪电，这样的冰炮就像火焰一般从天而降。那摧毁了很多的建筑物，以及摧毁了农作物的生长，而且打死了很多人，但是法老王还是继续拒绝。
After that, God sent locusts to eat the remaining crops and trees and to cover everything. Then after the Pharaoh still refused, the Egyptians experienced 3 days of darkness, where you couldn't see or do anything, but wait for it to lift. The Pharaoh still refused to let the children of Israel leave.
在这之后，上帝差使蝗虫去吃剩余的农作物以及植物，且让蝗虫掩盖吃尽所有每一样东西，但法老王还是继续拒绝。接着，埃及面临3天之久的黑暗笼罩着，那儿什么也看不到。也无法做任何事情，只有等待过去。但法老王还是拒绝以色列子民离开。
God told Moses he would send one last plague upon Egypt, and that the Pharaoh would then agree to let the people go. God would kill the firstborn of all the Egyptians, and their animals as well. The people of Israel needed to take the blood of a lamb and smear it on the sides and the top of the doors of their homes. Then the plague would pass by their houses.
上帝告诉摩西，他将降下最后一个灾难给予埃及，那法老王将会同意让以色列子民离开。上帝将击杀所有埃及人的头胎及所有动物牲畜的头胎，以色列人们则必须用羊血涂抹在他们的家门的两旁，或是及门的上端。那么这死亡之灾就会从他们家经过，而以色列的头胎即会平安无事。
This blood is very significant. We believe that Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God, and it is by his blood that we are all saved. God used the blood of a lamb to save Israel from being destroyed that night. They needed to eat a special meal that night, and we do every year up until now. It is called the Feast of Passover because the angel of death passed over them.
这血是非常有意义的，我们相信耶稣是上帝的羔羊，也因借着他的血，那我们才能够得以得救。上帝用这羊的血救了以色列人，得以躲避那天晚上的摧毁。那天晚上他们必须吃一餐非常特殊的一餐， 而且直到现在，每一年他们还是这样做，这称之为逾越节的盛宴，因为死亡的天使越过他们。
In the Taiwanese culture, you have a similar custom of putting red signs over your door and down the sides during Chinese New Year. It is to scare away bad spirits and to protect your home. Do you think it is possible that this tradition came from the time of Moses?
在台湾的文化习俗里，你们有一个类似的习俗，就是在中国新年里，你们贴放着红色的红帘在门槛上面以及门的两边，用这来吓走不好的灵，以及保护你们的家。你们想，这有没有可能这个传统是来自摩西的时代的呢？
After the firstborn was killed, which took the life of Pharaoh's son, the Pharaoh finally consented to let the people of Israel go. The people of Israel greatly rejoiced. They gathered up their belongings, and Moses took up the bones of Joseph so they could be buried in the promised land that they were heading to. God led them by a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. They stopped when they got to the Red Sea.
在头胎被杀死之后，这也夺走了法老王的儿子的命。这法老王终于同意以色列人们离开。以色列人们大大的喜乐，他们集合打包了他们的所有物，而摩西带着约瑟的骨灰，所以他们可以将他的骨灰埋葬在他们将去的应许之地。白天，上帝借着银柱带领他们，晚上用火柱带领他们。当他们到达了红海地，他们停了下来。
After the children of Israel had left Egypt, the Egyptians were mad with the Pharaoh. Now they did not have workers to keep building their cities. The Pharaoh prepared his chariots and invited 600 of his best warriors and went after the children of Israel. He found them trapped next to the Red Sea.
自以色列指民离开埃及后，埃及人非常生气法老王。现在他们没有工人为他们建造城市，法老王准备了他的战马车，以及带领了600位他最棒的战士去追赶以色列人民。他们发现到他们被陷在红海边。
The children of Israel were afraid when they saw the chariots, but Moses told them to not be afraid because God would fight their battles for them. Have peace. The pillar before them moved between them and the Egyptians. It kept the Egyptians from attacking them.
当以色列子民看到战车时，他们非常的害怕，但是摩西告诉他们不要害怕，因为上帝会为他们打这场征战，请安心吧。在前面行的云柱移动到他们与埃及人的中间，云柱正在保护着他们，不致受到埃及人的攻击。
Then God told Moses to take the staff in his hand and part the Red Sea. The people will be able to pass through on dry ground. Can you imagine a great body of water parting because a man commands it to do so? And on top of that, the place in the middle became dry land so you could pass on it. It was truly a miracle.
然后上帝告诉摩西举起他手里的手杖，分开红海，那人们就可以从干地经过。你可以想象吗？只因一个人的命令巨大的红海分开，而红海真的就这么分开了。你可以看到他们就在中间这样子，在这个干地里经过了。你
这真是一个奇迹。
When the Egyptians pursued after them, Moses caused the water to return, and all of the Egyptians drowned in the sea. The people of Israel rejoiced and knew that God was watching over them.
当埃及人在后面追逐他们时，摩西使红海的水反扑于他们，以致所有埃及人溺毙在红海里。以色列人们就非常的喜乐，且知道那是上帝在眷顾着他们。
As the children of Israel traveled on their way to the Promised Land, God provided water for them from rocks that Moses would tap. And God had a special kind of bread fall from the heaven 6 days a week, so they could have something to eat.
正当以色列的子民旅行在旅途在这个他们要去的应许之地的路途中，如那摩西愿意击打石头，上帝就会借着从石块供应水给他们，以及一星期六天，上帝会从天上降下一种非常特殊的面包，以致他们有得吃。
At one mountain, God called Moses up into the mountain, and he was up there for 40 days. God taught him all the laws and traditions that he wanted the people of Israel to follow. He taught them how to worship, how to sacrifice, and how to deal with one another. God also used his finger to write on tablets of stone the Ten Commandments.
在一座山上，上帝呼召摩西上到山上去，而他在山上待了有40天之久。上帝教导摩西所有的戒律以及传统，要以色列子民遵守。摩西教导他们要如何崇拜，要如何做牺牲祭，要如何彼此相处，而且上帝用了他的手写下了10诫在石碑上。
Moses led the people through the wilderness to the Promised Land. Many of them did not make it because of their wickedness, and even Moses, because he did not follow God's commandments exactly as he asked, was only allowed to see the Promised Land from a distance. He could not cross over the Jordan River and enter in.
Moses 带着子民经过荒野去到应许之地。因他们的软弱，有许多人并没有到达目的地。即便是摩西，也无法进入应许之地，只因为他并没有正确的追随上帝给予他的指示要求，只准摩西在有一段距离可以观望到应许之地而已。他并不可以跨越约旦河进入应许之地。
We learn from the story that God will guide and protect his people. He has many promises and blessings he would like to give us, but we must do as he asks of us. The life of Moses was incredible with the miracles he was able to see and perform. Soon we will see many of these plagues return to affect people in our day, right before Jesus Christ comes. We find that written in the book of Revelations.
我们从这个故事学习到，那上帝将会引导及保护他的子民。他有许多的应许及祝福，他喜欢给我们，但是我们必须去做他所要求我们应该做的事。那奇迹的发生，摩西的平生是非常不可思议的。他看得到奇迹，且自己还可以行神迹。在不久，在耶稣要再度回到世上之前，我们将会再度看到这十大灾难再度发生在我们现在的时代里。
Next week, we will talk about the Ten Commandments. In 2 weeks, we will continue on with the story of Joshua because he took over after Moses had to stay on the other side of the river. Let's finish our class by singing Peace Like a River.
下星期我们将谈论十诫的事情。在下下个星期我们将继续耶稣亚的故事，因为他接管了摩西的位置，而摩西必须待在河的另一边。让我们来唱平安有如江河，来结束今我们的课。
I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got joy like a mountain, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain in my soul.I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain in my soul. I've got love like an ocean, I've got love like an ocean, I've got love like an ocean in my soul. I've got love like an ocean, I've got love like an ocean, I've got love like an ocean in my soul.I've got peace like a river, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got love like an ocean in my soul. I've got peace like a river, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got love like an ocean in my soul.
Goodbye.